Let's check on European markets first. They are kicking off the new trading month in positive territory thanks to data showing manufacturing activity in the Eurozone rose to a 14-month high in April. This week, the European Central Bank will be in the spotlight with a rate cut expected on Thursday. As for Wall Street, futures are mixed after the major indices wrapped up the month of May, posting their sixth monthly gain in seven. And here are some stocks to watch out for. We are monitoring shares of meme stock GameStop after a post by the so-called Roaring Kitty trader reveals a huge position in the video game retailer. GameStop shares rallied 87% in the pre-market. Also in focus, shares of Paramount following reports Skydance Media revised an offer to purchase non-voting shares in the entertainment giant. Paramount shares rose 7% before the bell. We're also keeping a close watch on shares of GSK after a judge allowed more than 70,000 lawsuits involving its discontinued heartburn medication Zantac to proceed. The British drug maker last traded lower by 9%. We're also keeping an eye on shares of struggling French IT firm Atos. That is, the company weighs between two rescue deals that are both seem to lead to a massive dilution of existing shareholders. Atos shares stumbled 17% on the news. Asian markets greeted the new trading month on a positive note. That's after strong manufacturing data from the region. The Nikkei 225 climbed 1% as factory activity in Japan expanded for the first time in a year. The Shanghai Composite, however, bucked the rally even as data showed China's manufacturing PMI rose at its fastest pace in 2 years. Over in India, shares hit record highs as exit polls predict a landslide win for Prime Minister Narendra Modi. Investors are expecting Modi in his third term will expand his alliance's majority in parliament, leading to greater economic reforms. Meanwhile, here at home, the local bourse joined the upswing despite a slight dip in its manufacturing PMI.
It's relief rally that that May is gone and that the sell in May is gone. And of course, the MSCI outflows, related outflows, that's a big drag on the PCA. It's done and implemented, fully implemented. So we seem to be starting on a fresh start, fresh clean slate, hopefully. But of course, the headwinds are still there. We still have the weak peso. It's 58.50, and that's going to stay. It's not going to go away.
Some notable stock movements in the region, shares of Toyota and other auto stocks tumbled. That's after Japan's transport ministry found irregularities in applications to certify their models. The development represents a widening of a safety test scandal among Japanese automakers. And in Hong Kong, shares of Tencent Holdings jumped more than 4% on news the company and its unit Tencent Music will acquire a 10% stake in Thai entertainment platform GMM Music for $70 million. A check on the peso now. The local currency weakens anew versus the U.S. dollar. It closed at 58.68, lower than last Friday's 58.51. That's the lowest in 19 months. The Philippine Central Bank has said the peso's depreciation is only temporary as the dollar strengthens amid a delay in rate cuts from the U.S. Federal Reserve.